Welcome aboard. Now, the Detroit Express is going to start. 大家都上车了哈，现在这个底特律快车要开车了。Okay, let's go on with page 18. 所以第一个，虚脱环不能说我得虚脱环，那为什么呢？何以故？虚脱环名为入流，入流是你加一个字，入圣流啊，这个是入圣流，入上流，不是入下流，你知道啊，也不是入俗流，是入圣人的圣啊，入圣流。OK， 而无所入，什么叫入圣流呢？入圣流就是。入圣流就是不入俗流或是不入凡流。那什么是凡俗之流呢？凡俗之流就是色声香味触，就是六尘，对不对？你入了色声香味触六尘之流呢，就入凡了，对不对？那你出了色声香味触而不入，那就入圣流，对吧？啊，所以入圣流就无所入。无所入是指什么？对于六尘都不入，所以有个 dash 说不入色声香味触法、哦、那什么是俗呢？俗就是色声香味触法，这六个法呢，是好像灰尘一样，它会遮盖我们的心，令我们的心变成无明，因为盖住了嘛，好像灰尘一样。这比如说那个大陆的沙尘暴一到台湾，然后就铺天盖地啊，就乌烟弥漫了、啊、是不是就连太阳都看不住了，看不到了啊！所以就是这个就是六尘之流呢，可以让众生轮流生死，轮回生死。六尘之流那个比那个黑潮啊的力量还要大，你知道吧啊！所以那能够出这个六尘之流那是很不容易啊。你知道洋流知道吧啊，那个地球的那个洋流海潮啊，洋流就是太平洋大西洋那个那个 circulate 那个流啊，那个、很强很强的啊、哦、那众生的生死之流啊，色声香味触法构成这个六尘之流，构成六道轮转，这很强大的力量，这一般人是没有办法抵抗的啊，那只有修佛的清净法能够出六尘之流而出生死，这样的啊。所以这个虚脱环因为已经入了圣流，所以就出了尘流，出了凡流啊，所以就不入色声香味触法，这样子就不入就不染，不染就清净，所以称为虚脱环，这样的啊。The English part. Shubhuti replied, "Know your world veneration. This is a holy epithet of the Buddha. World veneration, which means that everybody should venerate him because he's got the highest wisdom and compassion. And why is it so? For Asuratapanna signifies stream ingression. Stream ingression meaning.To ingress, to enter into the holy stream. To ingress into the holy stream means to merge with the holiness. Okay. And by holiness means purification, purgation of one's impurities. So he hasingressed, entered in the stream of holiness. So he is purified. So, yet in reality, he never enters anywhere. Although he enters the holy stream, but he never enters anywhere worldly. Okay, you need to add one word, worldly. He does not.Enter into any worldly things, for never has he entered into either color, sound, odor, flavor, tactility, or dharma. These six are called dusts, the six dusts, because the dusts can cover up our mind, so make it darkened. So you will be blinded or blindfolded by the six dusts. So you cannot see through. You cannot see even. You become blind and become insensitive and even insensible to things, to people, you know. So to the ultimate degree, you become like a beast, you know, because you are insensible. Because your mental eye, your mind's eye is blinded, you know. So you cannot see at all. So you are, what, handicapped in the eye. So you become insensible and become brutish. Okay. Hence, he is entitled to the appellation of Sotapanna, because he would not get into the dusts of color, sound, odor, flavor, tactility, or dharma. He is not attached to these things anymore. And so he is free. He is free from all these dusts. So he is clean. He is clean. He is purified in the mind. So by the cleanliness or purgation of the mind, the Buddha means the holy stream. Okay. So there is anything to be gotten in the holy stream. If you got anything, then you are not holy. You know, to be a holy person in Buddhism, then you don't get anything. You are free from any attachment at all. So that's wisdom. And due to this kind of non-attachment wisdom, then you can be really compassionate. Because you are not attached to anything, so you are not thinking of yourself. So you do not consider anything in your own light and in your own benefit. And so you can totally give everything that you have and for the happiness of other people. So that's compassion. That's true compassion. You're not to gain anything in return for your compassion, for your service at all. That's really what the Buddha did. You know, he did not even demand anything, respect or offering from people. Even if he gave all his wisdom and compassion to everybody, you know. So Sotapanna, the first fruition holy person, he would not say, "I have got the first fruition of holiness." So I am a holy man. He would not say that. He cannot say that. If he say that I have got the holiness, then the moment he said that, he lose it, you know, because you have turned yourself into an ordinary people by that thinking. And by what virtue can you be called a holy person? It is only a turn of the mind, a very tiny turn of the mind that turn your worldliness into holiness. Understood? Okay. So it's only a little turn. So now here comes. I say that you need to know about the text of this sutra. It is for your protection and for your opening of your mental eye. Why? Especially in today's world, you've got all the holy men, all the enlightened people, everywhere. You know, if you walk in Manhattan, then it is pretty likely that you will run into a holy person or an enlightened person on the street. Okay. And if you drop a cabbage from the 9th floor down to the street, then it is very likely the cabbage will hit an enlightened man. You know. So we've got a lot of enlightened men in this world right now. So you hear everybody, a lot of people say, I'm enlightened, and or my teacher is enlightened, or so and so is enlightened, you know. 所以啊，我说这个《金刚经》，你这一段呢，一定要知道，这是为了保护你，你不会被误导，你知道吗？这个，因为我们现在开悟的人太多了，你知道吧？哎，你如果在那个。中国城啊，纽约中国城，你在第九楼把一个菠菜，一个那个 cabbage 怎么讲？高丽菜丢下来就会扎到一个开悟的人。哎，那如果扎不到的话，那一天就是你运气不好。哎，这一定要扎到的，因为开悟的人太多了，你知道吧？所以到处都是开悟的人，到处都是圣人，到处都是 living Buddhas， 你知道活佛。那所以 it's a wonderful world right now, you know. But you know, the Buddha said, even Shratapanna or Sakratamin and Aganamin and Arhat, no one, no holy man can say, I have got the holy status. Or to put it in this way, I am enlightened. I am purified. Okay, this is great. If you say, I am purified, the moment you say that, the words are not purified. The words are impure. You are not purified by saying you are purified. Right? 所以你说，我已经得到圣果，我已经清净了。你一讲说我已经清净，你那句话就不清净。你一说了就变成不清净了。那甚至于你不要说，你光是做试念说我清净，那就不清净。那甚至于不要说是清净，你说我持戒清净，那你就持戒就不清净了。这样的吗？这个是很 tricky 的一件事情，对不对？众生心就是这样，法如是故。哎，你清净就是清净，不清净就是你讲了清净就不清净了。Okay, so now I'll tell you. 悟者不言悟，言悟者不悟。所以如果有任何人说我已经开悟了，那他就没悟。那乃至于说啊，谁也已经开悟了啊，谁的徒弟也开悟了，现在很多说啊，某一个大师，然后他下面有几个也都已经开悟的弟子，这些都是谣言，而且都是不正确，不可以讲。你开悟了就开悟了，不能讲开悟。你一讲开悟，那就是迷，那就是没悟。你的迷那个悟，你懂吗？听懂吗？你迷那个悟，然后自以为悟了，那事实上还在迷中，才会讲说我悟了。你悟什么？你悟了，伦敦大悟，台湾话说悟煞煞，你悟煞煞，母煞煞，So, by the holy edict and the doctrine of the Buddha, one who is enlightened would not say he is enlightened.And one who says he is enlightened, he is not enlightened. If he says so, then he turns himself into an unenlightened person by saying, I am enlightened. Okay, so this is for your protection. You need to know the doctrine and the ultimate truth of Buddha's doctrine. You need to know. So why we are cheated? Why we are deceived? Why are we misled? Because we don't know the situation. We don't know the true status of the Dharma. Because we are not aware of the Dharma, so we are deceived. So from now on, don't believe so quickly that, oh, he's enlightened, he's a holy man. Then you will kowtow to him. That will make a fool of yourself. Okay, so because the Buddha says so plainly that one who is enlightened would not say or could not say that he is enlightened. The moment he says he is enlightened, then he is unenlightened. Okay? So, because we have so many innumerable enlightened people, Buddhas and living Buddhas everywhere, you know? So, I wouldn't think that we are so lucky. We have so many Buddhas right now. But according to the Buddha's doctrine, at one period of time, there is only one Buddha, no other one. And by one Buddha, meaning such as this Shakyamuni Buddha, we are still in his Dharma. We are still in the period of his Dharma. His Dharma consists of three periods. Okay, the right Dharma period and the quasi Dharma period and the finite Dharma period. And right now we are in the finite Dharma that is turning to the final. It's very little now. The Dharma is very little, very few now. But we still have the Dharma. So we are still in the Dharma of Shakyamuni Buddha. And this Dharma has lasted 2,500 years now. And it's going to last for 10,000 years. And after that, there will be no Dharma at all. And no Sangha, no priests or monks like me. And you will see monks shaving their heads and wearing the robe, but no practicing of the Dharma. You know, just appearance. Okay. But right now, we still have the Dharma here. A lot of Dharma right now. Only we don't know how to practice it. We don't know the true meaning of it. But I'm, by this chance, revealing the true meaning of the Dharma to you, so that you would not be beguiled. So don't be gullible, easily cheated. Okay, I don't know why a gull is called easily cheated. Gull 是海鸥啊，像海鸥一样就是很容易被骗呐。哎，不知道为什么海鸥会容易骗呢？但是一个很容易被骗的啊，很容易上金光党的当的啊，就叫 gullible， 英文就叫 gullible， OK， 所以变成不要变成海鸥啊，哎，那要不要变成海鸥呢？那你就必须要懂得佛法，你懂得佛法，你是行家，就没有人能够骗得了你。但是除了你是行家以外，你还怎么样呢？最重要，不能贪爱。我说哦，我已经开悟了，我有神通等等啊。那你贪爱神通，贪爱种种怪现象，那你就被迷了，就着魔了。Okay, so besides the knowledge of the right Dharma, you still need one thing to protect yourself from the wrong Dharmas and from the wrong people, you know, who claim that they are enlightened. What's that? You are not to be attached to any supernatural things. Okay. Anybody claims he is enlightened and he has supernatural powers, don't believe it so quickly. Don't be gullible, okay? Because that may be the manifestation of the Mara's work. The Mara's work, okay? So beware of it. So it's very important that you know this. Okay, now, so it's for the first fruition and for the second fruition, third, fourth, the arhatkhood, it's all the same. You cannot say that I have obtained arhatkhood, or even you cannot think about it, you know. So in English, we have this expression, don't even think about it, right? If you think about it, then you turn yourself into a worldly person, not a holy person, okay? Now, the express is going to the next station, page 22. And this is very important too.二十二页，第特地快车开到二十二页了，你庄严净土分，佛告须菩提，于云何如来习在燃灯佛所，于法有所得否？佛也世尊，如来在燃灯佛所，于法实无所得。佛在燃灯佛所是正道菩提，对不对？他开悟，然后被燃灯佛授记，你将来要成佛，号为释迦牟尼佛，对不对？那么开悟了，开悟应该是得菩提嘛，对不对？照我们的想法就是得菩提，那为什么现在须菩提问他说，你在燃灯佛那是古佛，燃灯佛一尊古佛，很久以前的古佛，那个时候呢，世尊你那时候在法上有没有所得呢？佛就说没有，这个，就是佛问须菩提，然后须菩提就回答说，世尊在燃灯佛所那里没有所得，为什么？ 得菩提应该是有所得，要不然没有得菩提，怎么成佛呢？对不对？好，我告诉你，佛成佛是什么？是正道佛性，佛性，正佛性成为成佛，对不对？那佛性是本有，一切众生都是从无始以来就本有，本来就有的，所以不是燃灯佛给他的佛性，是释迦牟尼佛。 那个时候就已经有佛性了，只不过燃灯佛指示他怎么样见到自己的佛性，所以因此而悟到菩提，这样的吗？佛性悟了佛性就是菩提了，所以这个佛性不是任何人给你的，不是从佛得，也不是从外得，不是佛能够给你佛性，你佛性你本来就有。 只不过佛指示出来，让你自己去找出来，就好像你有一个金山，那你不知道那个金子藏在哪里，那这个有一个人会，就内行人，然后他是 professional， 他会看探勘呐，然后看出来说你的那个宝藏在哪里，这样的，那指出来给你，指出来给你是什么？就达摩直指人心，就是这样的吗？ 达摩直指人心，这是人心什么？就是你的本性宝藏，叫你去悟那个东西。你悟到了，你就是开悟了，就是成佛了，那如果没有完全看到，没有见到的话，那就是没有开悟，所以佛对于乃至于菩提都是不是有所得，有所得都是一定要什么呀？你要有所得，一定要往外攀援，往外缘取得。 缘取得，这样的，所以但是菩提或是悟性呢，是本来自有的。你如果要往外缘取得的话，那么就是往外攀缘，往外攀缘，心外见法称为外道，就不是佛道，这样的吗？好，OK， 那所以这个就是佛法里面的一个很甘心的地方。 佛法的甘心啊，就最重要的心啊，就是 往内推求，而不是往外持足啊。所以那因为什么？因为我这个菩提自性是在自己自心里面啊。好，the English part. The Buddha told Subhuti, "What dost thou make of it? Did the less Adventist make any attainment in the Dharma when he was at the premises of Lamb Lighting Buddha?" What do you think that did the Buddha, less Adventist, the Buddha get anything in the Dharma when he was at the place of the Lamb Lighting Buddha? Lamb Lighting Buddha was an antediluvian Buddha, a very far away, ancient Buddha. At that time, the Shakyamuni Buddha was still a Pusa, and he was practicing under this Buddha. And he was enlightened at that time, and that Buddha, Lamb Lighting Buddha, ordained him by saying, "You are going to be a Buddha in the future in the holy name of Shakyamuni." So he was enlightened at that time. And so obviously he has got the enlightenment and has got Bodhi. So, but Subhuti rejoined, "No, your world veneration, in reality, the Dutch Adventist did not make any attainment in the Dharma at the premises of Lamb Lighting Buddha." So, why? Because you need to know, and this is very, very crucial, significant, important. What is Buddha? Now we have all learned Buddhism. What is Buddha? Buddha is one who has witnessed his own Buddha nature. So this is also the doctrine of the Buddha, of Buddhism. Buddha nature, Mahayana Buddhism. Everybody, why? All beings are equal. Because all beings are endowed with Buddha nature. So everybody is a potential Buddha. Everybody can be a Buddha just by practicing. And by practicing, you clear away all the obstacles and impurities and impediments so that you can see for yourself your Buddha nature. Once you have viewed or witnessed your own Buddha nature, then you become a Buddha. And there is no other way. And this is the only way. Okay. And there is no way roundabout. Okay. It is direct toward your own mind. And the Buddha nature lies in your own mind. So nobody can give you that. You have it. You have always had it. Only you missed it. Only you did not see it. And so you think you don't have it. Like in the Lotus Sutra, one who has an ingot, a chunk of gold in within his robe, but he did not know it. So he thought that he was poor. So he went begging as a beggar, you know, but actually he is a wealthy man without knowing it. So we are the same. We have a very precious thing within here, but we think we are very poor, we are desolate, you know, we are indigent. But actually we are wealthy with all the riches of Buddha nature, but we don't see it. It is not just we don't see it, we don't feel it, and we are even unaware of it. We are unaware of our own Buddha nature. So we cannot utilize it. We cannot put it to use. So that's what makes us very poor. We are impoverished by our own ignorance. By our own ignorance of our own wealth. And the highest wealth would be Buddha nature. So the one thing that we need to do in practicing Buddhism is to get to witness our own Buddha nature. So if we do this, then by viewing Buddha nature for ourselves, then we know we are wealthy. We will possess every desirable things in the world. So this Buddha nature is yours. Only you are unconscious of it. And so you think you don't have it. So you look around and chase about for it. And you seek for it everywhere. But if you seek everywhere, then you are not going to find it. Because it is right in here. And if you seek everywhere, you won't find it. If you find, then it is not yours. 这样听得吗? 所以你如果到外面去找的话,你即使找到了说,哦,有物,那个物不是你的。 因为那个物应该是你自己的佛性,那是你的。 但是你在外面找到的物呢,那是别人的。 哎呦, okay, so this is so important. Okay, this is the end of the world. Next sentence is so important, okay.
四故须菩提，看到没有？那个二十二页，四故须菩提，菩萨摩诃萨因如是生清净心，不因住色生心，不因住声香味触法生心，因无所住而生其心。这个太重要了嘛，对不对？这个是禅宗的六祖大师开悟的句子，对不对？事实上，一切大师开悟都有这一个东西在里面，啊，所以那我就简单讲一下，这个心要。 要生清净心，就心不要让它污染，啊！而且你要生心，生心的生什么？因无所住而生其心，这其心是什么？ 很 ambiguous， 对不对？大悲心，你无所住，无所住就自己解脱了，然后无所住解脱了，自己解脱有大智慧，但是要生大悲心，要生大悲度众之心。 叫做生起心，OK，啊，所以，now the English part，as a consequence， page 23， as a consequence， quote the Buddha， Subhuti， all Pusa Mahasattvas， are incumbent to generate， the purified heart in such wise， all the great Pusas。 Are supposed to generate the pure or purified heart in this way. They should not be attached to matter while generating the heart. Matter meaning objects, concrete objects. Nor should they be attached to sound, smell, flavor, tactility, dharma while generating the heart. Insofar, that they should not reside in any way while generating the heart. So, they still should generate the heart. What does the heart mean? It means the heart of compassion or the compassionate heart that enables you to deliver all beings. You want to, or you are willing to deliver all beings. And but you are not attached to anything. So, you are not attached to anything means you are purified, but which means you are liberated from all bondages. And that's wisdom. But to have wisdom and to be self-liberated is not all. The final goal is to use your own wisdom to deliver all beings.
问题时间就不管了，等一下再说。
So you should not reside in any way. You are not supposed to be attached to anyway. But you should still, you are purified in yourself, but you should have the compassionate heart to deliver all beings. Okay, so this is a great sentence that rendered the sixth patriarch of Chan Buddhism, Zen Buddhism, enlightened. When he heard the interpretation of this sentence from his master, the fifth patriarch, and he became enlightened. But actually, most all great patriarchs were enlightened in the similar way, you know, from this, because purify, but still purify is self-liberated. And if you have got liberation, then it's not final. It's not the intention of the Buddha. The Buddha means that you get your liberation from my teaching, and you should pass this liberation to others. You know, others should be benefited by your liberation too. You should pass this experience to others. Okay, so you are not just take this liberation and that's it. Then you are becoming a Hinayana person. Okay, so you should practice Mahayana. Mahayana meaning you practice yourself and you get the result and become purified and liberated. And then you use the same method, tell others the same method to get liberated. Okay, so that's the perfect thing. You know, you will do this due to the teaching of the Buddha. Okay, page 47. 47页, very quickly, this is super express. Okay, 须菩提于云何如来有肉眼否？ 如是世尊如来有肉眼否？如是世尊如来有天眼否？如是世尊如来有天眼。须菩提，于云何如来有慧眼否？如是世尊如来有慧眼。须菩提，于云何如来有法眼否？如是世尊如来有法眼。须菩提，于云何如来有佛眼否？如是世尊如来有佛眼。完了。OK， 雾煞煞，对不对？一塌糊涂，不知道什么意思。那我告诉你，肉眼是什么？肉眼是众生的眼。 对，凡夫眼，对不对？那么佛有佛应该有佛眼，这没问题啦，对不对？但佛有肉眼，有凡夫眼吗？我告诉你，这个是一层一层增进的。那这个佛他还虽然已经有佛眼，但是还是保持的肉眼，表示什么？不舍众生，佛不舍众生，所以他还是为众生设。 设身处地来考虑着想，所以是完完全全没有我执我见，没有我慢，对不对？说我是佛啊，我有佛眼，我有佛眼，为什么要用凡夫眼？对不对？是不是？如果你有佛眼的话，你要用凡夫眼吗？那用佛眼多好，一看就是看了三千大千世界，对不对？但是佛就不是这样子啊，他还是保持凡夫眼，然后他面对凡夫的时候就用凡夫眼来看。 你知道吧？然后，所以才会知道凡夫怎么想，设身处地说：“哦，你为什么这样那样那样？而且
看到他那样子，然后再用这个圣人的眼来看，哦，这你会这么想的原因是什么？在照用佛眼照见，你知道吧？否则你自用佛眼看，说，哎呀，这么简单的问题都搞不清楚，是笨，不教你了，是不是啊？所以，就佛完全没有我执、我见、我慢，就是如来有肉眼，还是这个不舍欲界众生啊。然后第二句，如来有天眼佛，天眼是什么？天眼是色界的众生，所以佛也是一样，不舍色界的众生，就天界的啊。那还是这个为色界的这个天界天人呐、啊，设身处地，然后为他们着想啊。然后如来有慧眼佛，慧眼是什么？是二圣的啊，就是声闻缘觉的啊。那也佛有慧眼，还是保持慧眼；有佛眼，还是保持慧眼。然后可以照见这个二圣众生，他们的心态，然后依他们的那个处境，设身处地去想，所以完全摒除了如来的我执、我见、我慢啊。然后如来有法眼佛，法眼是菩萨的眼啊，菩萨法眼清净啊。那法眼清净又称为法眼净啊，所以这个法眼净，干净的净，不是眼镜那个 glasses 啦啊，法眼清净啊。那佛有没有菩萨的法眼呢？有。那为什么？因为佛也是要为菩萨做设身处地啊。而且表示他没有我执、我见、我慢。那如来有佛眼佛，那为什么还要问如来有佛眼佛？那当然是有啊。那这不是废话吗？不是废话，表示什么？如来保持了肉眼、天眼、慧眼、法眼，但是不舍无上菩提，所以有佛眼，这样的吗？所以这个如来有佛眼，是表示如来不舍无上菩提，所以他一切都拥有，同时，同时都拥有啊、哦，所以那以前那个电影不是有什么，Technicolor 叫什么什么综合，记得吗？就是那个彩色电影刚出来的时候啊，不理了，往下看，问你们都没用，好 ，Subhuti called the Buddha, the English part. What dost thou make of this? 不用敲了啊。Is the thus advantaged possessed of naked eyes? Does the Buddha have naked eyes? And Subhuti said, Verily, truly, your world veneration, the thus advantaged is possessed of the naked eyes. And Subhuti, does the Buddha have naked eyes? And naked eye means the ordinary people's eyes.And Subhuti quoth the Buddha, what dost thou make of this? Is the thus advantaged possessed of celestial eyes? Celestial eyes means the eyes of the material realm. That's heavenly people, heavenly beings. And what does this mean? Now we go on.Verily, rejoined Subhuti, your world veneration, the thus advantaged, is possessed of celestial eyes. Subhuti quoth the Buddha, what dost thou make of this? Is the thus advantaged possessed of sagacious eyes? Verily, rejoined Subhuti, your world veneration, the thus advantaged, is possessed of sagacious eyes. Subhuti quoth the Buddha, what dost thou make of this? Is the thus advantaged possessed of dharmic eyes? Verily, rejoined Subhuti, your world veneration, the thus advantaged is...possessed of dharmic eyes. Subhuti quoth the Buddha, what dost thou make of this? Is the thus advantaged possessed of dharmic eyes, Buddhaic eyes? Verily, rejoined Subhuti, your world veneration, the thus advantaged is possessed of dharmic eyes. Okay, what does that mean? When the naked eye is the ordinary people's eyes, so what does that mean? It means thatThe Buddha is not egocentric. He is compassionate. Although he has the Buddha's eye, but he still sees
he still is willing to see things in the light of common people. So he is not egoistic. So he is not arrogant. You know, so he is free from egoistic views and egoistic love. So he would not forsake or desert common people. So he would, in the English expression, to stand in our own shoes, to see things in our own light. Okay, so it is the same. The next paragraph, celestial beings, meaning the heavenly beings, who are higher than us, the desire realm. They are in the material realm, but they are not holy yet. And the Buddha would see things in their eyes too, so that he can totally understand what they are thinking about and what their feelings are. So, and he is free from arrogance, egocentricism. And does the Buddha have sagacious eyes? Sagacious eyes is the Hinayana saints' eyes, Hinayana holy people's eyes, and which means the Buddha would not also desert Hinayana people, although they are not an ideal, but he would not desert them, and so he would still see things in their eyes, in their light, and to be considerate of them and solve their problems for them. So he is not egocentric, not arrogant. Okay. And so, you know, the most important thing in Buddhism is that Buddha is not arrogant. Buddha is majestic, but he is not arrogant. And he is not humble either. You know, it is ridiculous to say that the Buddha is humble, right? Just as you say, the king is humble. That would be ridiculous, right? But the Buddha is not humble, and neither humble nor arrogant. No. 所以, 佛不是谦虚, 谦虚是道家的事情, 谦虚嘛, 假的。 谦虚就是假的，中国人就是搞这一套了，你知道吗？这从道家来的，哎，这佛一点也不谦虚，啊，但是他也不高傲，懂吗？他就是真实，啊，这就是佛的智慧，这就是我所说的佛的可爱，你知道吗 ？He is adorable, 哎，所以the Buddha would not, relinquish the Dhyanayists. And does the Buddha have dumbing eyes, the Pusa or Bodhisattva's eyes? Which means the Buddha would not relinquish or forsake Pusas. So he also sees things in Pusa's eyes. And the last thing, does the Buddha have Buddhic eyes? Of course. But why does Subhuti ask this, or the Buddha asks this? It means the Buddha has the Buddhic eyes, means the Buddha, although he still keeps various levels of understanding and enlightenment, but he will not relinquish the Supreme Body at any time. Okay, and the Buddhic eye signifies the Supreme Body. Okay, so he keeps the five eyes. So you see, the text is simple, but Maybe this is the first time you get to understand this. And page 49. Now, the next station. The next, 第二行, 第二段, 须菩提, 佛告须菩提, 而所国土中, 所有众生, 若干种心, 如来悉知, 何以故如来说, 诸心, 皆非, 皆为非心, 名为心, 所以者何, 须菩提, 过去心不可得, 现在心不可得, 未来心不可得, This is very important, right? Okay. So, 所有的烦恼啊, 都是从回忆来的, 就是说意想分别, 因此有烦恼, 所以, 我们就总是要回忆过去啊, 但是这个过去心不可得, 所以要常常想, 所以也不要去常常去, 你虽然照相, 但是照了相以后不要去看它, 因为那已经过去了, 你看了干什么? 所以我都是照了以后不看这样的, 因为你看了你就会想嘛, 然后想说啊, 我那时候多么年轻啊, 然后就啊, 我现在多么老啊, 对不对? 好, 所以种种的意想分别就烦恼了, 那现在心不可得, 那, 现在因为过去已过不可得, 现在不住, 所以不可得, 未来, 还没有到, 未来未至, 所以不妄想, 这样的, 好, at the bottom of this page, the Buddha told Subhuti, the all and sundry of minds of all the multi-beings in those Ganges same number of Buddhaic universes, the thus advanced could perceive them all perspicaciously. Wherefore is it so? For the minds that the thus advanced enunciates are non-minds, hence they are denominated as minds. What is the reason for this, Subhuti? For the past minds are unobtainable. The present minds are unobtainable. The future minds are unobtainable. Okay. The first important thing is the past minds are unobtainable. Because all the afflictions or vexations come from memory. We remember and we reminisce all the things in the past. So we become fretted. So in order to be free, which means to be free from our own minds, but we always recall all the past things, so that we don't want to let go. So these two sentences tell us to let go of everything. And don't recall the past, because it's past. It's no use to recall it. And the present would not stay. It would not dwell. So don't grasp it. If you grasp it and you think you are going to have it forever, for instance, later we are going to take a picture, everybody. And so we will make this moment stay forever in that picture, right? And that's a mistake. But for me, that mistake is only to be done once, because after taking it, I'm not going to see it anymore. Okay, I'm not going to remember all the good old days, you know. Because if it is good old days, then it is the bad present day right now. So I don't want the contrast and the worry and sorry feeling of it. The future has not come yet, so don't think about it, you know. And if it comes, then it will come. Okay. So let's take care of it in the future when it comes. Please bear with me. I want to read this a little bit. conclusion of the sutra. I have prepared lots of things, but I'm unable to finish it. So let it be. Okay, I let go of it.
Okay, 放下。我准备太多了，就讲不完了。应该要讲到32分的。第32分，一切有为法，如梦幻泡影，如露亦如电，应作如是观，也不讲了啊。那中文版呢，我等那个台湾那个网络直播哈，讲那个小止观讲完了，我就讲金刚经。哎，那但英文的就没办法了。OK, now the conclusion of this sutra, and I'll tell you, to your surprise, I have finished this sutra. I have finished with this sutra already. Okay, for your information. And now I'm making a conclusion of it. Now then, what does this sutra mean? The Diamond Sutra. What is the purpose of the Diamond Sutra? Or, in our dear friend Peter's terms, can you tell me in a very short, simple sentence, what is the most important idea or purpose of the Diamond Sutra? Yes, I will try to. The gist of Diamond Sutra is to break adherence. To break adherence. 破执。金刚经的要义是干什么？它的目的是什么？最重要首要就是破执，破执着。Okay. Or destroy the obstinacy or stubbornness. All people are stubborn in their own way. Okay. Or tenacity or pertinacity. 坚固执着。Why? For our liberation to be free from bondage. We need to do that. To break the adherence. 为了我们的解脱，我们必须要破执着。所以金刚是什么？金刚破惑，对不对？惑是什么？惑的最大的就是执着，起先是迷糊模糊糊里糊涂，然后最后就执着了，执着那个糊里糊涂。所以我们都很执着，执着那个糊涂，执着那个无明，你知道吧？哎，所以为了要得解脱，所以就要破无明，破执着啊，执着破，无明就破了啊。So,In order to be free from bondage, we need to break adherence. Adherence is bondage. The reason why we are unliberated is not because we are bound by external factors. 我们之所以不得解脱，不是我们被外面的东西绑住了。有人说，哎呀，我就是被我老公绑住，要不然我早就出家了。胡扯。你被你对你老公的爱绑住了，所以你不出家。那啊，我就是为了放不下我的孩子啊，所以啊，所以要不然我就早就出家了。拜托，不要讲要不然啊，那个你不是被孩子绑住了，是你被你对你孩子的爱绑住了，是你自己的爱绑住你自己，懂吗 ？OK。所以没有人绑住你，是你自己绑自己。那你自己用什么绑自己？你自己用你自己的爱绑自己，这样的。OK, 你像一只蜘蛛精，自己吐丝自己绑自己。OK, 啊，蜘蛛精知道吧？有没有看过《西游记》？啊，好，那女的叫蜘蛛精，男的叫蜘蛛怪了，对不对？啊 ，So we are.Not bound by external factors, but bound by our own attachments and adherences, 贪爱执着。So what is diamond or vajra in Sanskrit? 什么是金刚呢？无欲则刚，对不对？连老子都说无欲则刚。你如果没有欲，欲就是贪爱。你若不贪爱，你就很坚强。你一有贪爱你就软了，因为贪爱是什么？贪爱是火，它可以融化一切，你知道吗？好， So what is diamond? If one is unattached then he becomes diamond, then he becomes Vajra. Okay, so if one can be unattached to anything, then one would be as strong and unbreakable like Vajra, which is the strongest, most precious stone in the world. So the intention or purpose of this sutra is telling you this. Okay. Then what does breaking adherence signify? 所以破执着呢是代表什么意思啊？破执着就是改变你固定的行为、固定的观点、信念、想法、看法，就是破执着。And what does breaking adherence signify? It means to transform or change your fixed behavior, your fixed views, your fixed opinions, and your fixed opinions.So, if you change it, then you become Vajra. You become strong. You purify by taking out, purify yourself by taking out the impurities. All of these would amount to form the, to form karma or karmic habitude. So, all the fixed behavior, fixed ideas or thinkings will become your karmic habitude. 这些固定的行为、想法、观念、信念都变成我们的业习力，固定了嘛？啊，所以，how to do this diamond portal? How to practice it? How to coordinate the understanding with action in real life?So, 怎么样把这一个金刚法门把它做出来，在生活上做出来，在心里面做出来，而不是说在心里面以及生活上做出来，而不是说只是看看经就完了啊。Diamond Prajna, it is generally understood that Prajna is vacuity or emptiness. 这个金刚波诺，一般讲波诺就是什么？就是空，对不对？那而且讲这个波诺法门，波诺的空的法门最重要的就是金刚经，对不对？可是我问你，这整部金刚经里面你有没有看到一个空字？没有。 Surprise, 对不对？啊， So you even cannot find one word of vacuity or emptiness, because it is generally understood thatVacuity or emptiness is the meaning of prajna. So, and actually, this sutra does not talk about vacuity, but seemingly contrarily, it keeps talking about bestowal or donation. 所以这部经啊不讲空，而讲什么？而讲施，讲舍，讲布施，对不对？从头到尾都在讲布施，是不是？好。Then.This is the secret key to the portal of diamond prajna bestowal. To the portal of diamond prajna. 这个金刚经的这个这秘密的钥匙是什么？秘密的钥匙就是施布施。所以你不是一天到晚你去了解空啊谈空啊什么然后能够得到波诺，不是。你从布施里面求波诺。那什么叫布施呢？布施就是舍嘛，舍了就没有了，对不对？啊，没有了，所以是空，这样的嘛。你看，这很有意思吧？所以跟你一般所了解的这个空是完全两回事的。而且你这个在施舍的时候呢，你自己空了，你自己不执着了，你自己没有染污了，但是利益了他人。所以这同时自利利他，而且就同时去向菩提，成就佛道，都在这个舍上。所以舍自己最喜欢的东西给别人，叫做舍，啊，叫做施，不是舍自己所喜爱的，而不是说舍自己不需要的、不喜欢的，然后给人家。不是，你若舍自己不喜欢的东西，那个叫做 recycle， 对，所以就不是诗了，你懂啊？ So in bestowal by itself, it coordinates not at once both self-practice and benefiting others. 是自修利他。Bestowal or donation is the golden key, or rather, diamond key to everything. Bestowal or donation is to give something one loves to others for their happiness or benefit. Not giving something you don't need or you don't like. And that will be recycled waste, not donation. So...When you donate, you need to donate something you love, you know. So, what is donation or bestowal? Give and give up, or give up and give. You need to give up first and then give. Give up something and then give it to others. That's donation. That's bestowal. And give up something from your mind so you are.Purify, you are not attached, and then give to others, you benefit others. So both ways are benefited. You are benefited by the purification. Others, get the increase of things, or even knowledge or wisdom. So, how to practice this? 怎么样修呢？第一个我就很快念过去哈，减少贪爱的东西啊，渐渐的减少，没有要求你很快啊，渐渐的减少贪爱的东西，你贪爱东西，我们贪爱的东西太多了，渐渐减少，你不要学佛越学越贪爱，那就没用啊。第二个呢，减少贪爱的强度啊，你不要还是那么贪爱，那学了就没用啊。 So how to practice graduallydecrease, the things that you love. Okay. And second, decrease the intensity of your love. 第三个，随顺他人的意见。Comply with others' opinions. Okay. Comply with others' opinions. Don't always win. Okay.你不要每一次都是你赢，你知道吧？顺别人的意思一点啊，这就是什么？这就是放弃我执，你懂吗？我执我见，怎么修？就这样修啊！你不要老是你每一次讲话你都赢了，辩论你都赢了，然后你老公总是输你了，对不对？那你儿子呢？也必定要一定要听你的，不听你的话就零用金就减少了，对不对？那 Don't always win. Let others win sometimes. Okay. I got a phrase. Always win, always lost. 你老是赢，你就总是输。Okay. 你每赢一次就输一次，你知道吗？所以到后来你就很凄惨，你知道吗？因为你输得惨惨的嘛，对。Okay. So don't always win. Okay. If you always win,You always lost. You are always lost. So, and this is giving up your own ego, your own egoistic opinions. Okay. And your egoistic love for yourself. And egoistic love for your own opinions. So, don't be so opinionated. 不要自我主见太强啊。所以要学会随顺他人，这很难呢。这个要做啊，这就是波诺，你知道吗？这是智慧，这也是慈悲，对。So this is wisdom. Give up your own opinion. This is wisdom, and this is compassion too. You know. So you practice both at the same time. So this is prajna, supreme, right? 所以现在下面这个就更难了。这个我从初中就开始修这个啊，学习体贴体谅他人。Next item is even more important. Learn or try to learn, be considerate of others. What does be considerate
of others mean? You take others into consideration.
你把别人考虑在内。你不要，你就是很伟大无量的光芒，然后把所有的人都罩住了，你很罩，对不对？或者是因为你很大，所以啊，你的阴影啊，把所有的人都罩住了，也是罩，对不对？啊，都盖住了，哎，所以啊，不自私，不只为自己想，而都不考虑他人。下面这个，努力去做哈，讲话的时候让别人先讲，啊，然后譬如我讲电话的时候，电话一拿起来，就说，哎，你那里怎么样啊？不要电话一讲讲起来说，哎，我怎么样？我儿子怎么样？我老公怎么样？怎么样？都只讲你自己，然后别人都，因为你那个话太快了，根本插进去都插不进去，然后都是听你在讲，那别人都没有机会讲，哎。然后先问别人有什么事，然后最后自己再讲你的事，对。那如果他实在不那么体贴，他不会，他自己讲完了，然后那也没问你说，哎，你那里怎么样啊？那你那时候你就大胆一点，就说啊，我这里怎么样，你自己讲嘛，啊，这样的，啊，就不要客气了，他讲完了嘛，啊，好，所以啊，不要都是你在讲，也不要抢着讲。不要讲个不停，哎，不要讲个不停，要喘一喘气，你知道吧？啊，不要老是你在讲，不要插嘴。还有，别人讲话的时候专心的听，啊，不要表面上装着在听别人讲话，这个骨子里嘛在打草稿。等他一讲完，我就马上就接下去了。他说他讲什么也不知道。就是只是听到一个声音，等那个声音一断了，马上就进攻了，你知道？那就怎么就我执嘛，对不对？所以啊，这个搞了半天是什么呢？搞了半天呢，每一个人大家都在讲，但是没有人在听。这是我从小学五年级开始跟着我妈妈，然后这个。各大妈们，这个老妈大妈们这边聊天的时候观察所得，每个人都在讲，但是没有人在听。你这个所谓的三姑六婆在讲话的时候都是这样子，你去注意看看，哎，这就是我执我见。So how to practice it? Listen to others and don't always talk and don't interrupt and don'tfind a way to talk all the time and listen to others. And when you listen attentively. Okay. You don't pretend that you are listening, but actually you are preparing your draft. And when he stops, then I will cut in very quickly, you know, because time is money. I won't lose it, you know. So in the end,You see a group of people talking together, but everybody is talking, but no one is listening. That's what I have found out when I was a child, when I was with my mother, and she was talking with all the mothers in the neighborhood, but everybody is talking, but nobody listening. That's very interesting. So that's ego.Now, that's egocentric. So now you have learned Buddhism, and especially you have learned most of the Diamond Sutra. Then, so you need to practice it. Okay. So get away with your egocentric fixation. Fixation, 知道吧？这是个心理学名词，这坚固啊啊。所以啊。这一切我刚刚所说都是在去我执，去我执，去我相，舍我相执着。So, all this is to let go of your adherence, ego adherence, ego appearance. And so, forego, relinquish, all these. And I was saying, when you give up or forego things, you give up the most precious, beloved things. And what is the most precious, beloved things? It is not objects. It's not the external property. The most precious things that we think they are precious are own minds, our own ideas, our own feelings. So, it's my feeling, I won't give up. It's my thinking, I won't give up. You know, so give up your own thinking. Because after all, your own thinking is a worldly thinking. So it's not worth keeping. Okay? 所以我说要放弃你的那个所心爱的东西，你最心爱的是什么？你最心爱的就是你的想法，你的意见，还有你的想法、你的意见、你的感情，所以想法、意见、感情，这感情是说爱呀、恨呐、这些啦，不是叫你放弃你对你老公的爱了。但是也可以减少一点，要不然你就比较不会痛苦了，你知道吗？你就是爱得太深了，所以这么苦啊！你看，我看你每一个都是苦瓜脸这样的，就是为爱而苦啊，可怜可怜。So you need to break through your die-hard thinking, your fixed mentality.Arrogance. So this is the hardest part of ego appearance, arrogance. 我慢 Okay. So the progress of bondage is outreaching, grasping, appropriating, attachment, and then arrogance. So this is the last stage.这个戏服啊的那个次第是怎么样进行的是怎么样首先是缘攀缘然后取缘取有然后有又执执以后因为只有这东西而慢这样的所以缘取有执慢啊那到了慢了以后就癌症末期癌症末期是什么稳死的就死定了所以一个人如果傲慢那就死定了就一切都改不了了就等着入安宁病房了安宁病房知道吗就是大家在给你为你念阿弥陀佛那里了 So if you become arrogantThen it's the final stage of your cancer. Okay. And you will be domineering, controlling, overbearing. 就跋扈，你知道吗？你傲慢嘛，所以跋扈。So, finally, I'll make an, but ego appearance, and well, there are four appearances. Ego appearance, alter appearance, multi-being appearance, and the lifetime,Lifespan appearance, 有四项对不对 The quadruple appearances. I'll give a new, brand new interpretation of the four appearances. What is ego appearance? 什么是我相 I am the best, 我最棒。这就是 ego appearance. What is the alter appearance? 什么是人相You are inferior. 你差得远。He is no good. 他不行。She is nothing. 他不是东西。这就是人相。因为由我相照见人相嘛。To see others from your point of view.
What is multi-being appearance? 什么是众生相？ They are all stupid. 所以我相、人相、众生相就是这样子。哎，我相我最棒，人相你不行，众生相众生都是愚痴的，就这样了。哎，这是这个四相的这个最新的诠释。OK, I have skipped some pages, but I finally made it, and I would tell you, 把那个六祖坛进来。So this is the last class for this season, and I'm going back to Taiwan on August 7th, and I'll be back in next spring. I'm like a seasonal bird. Okay, and when I come back, the second coming, I will make an interpretation of this one. The Altar Sutra of the Sixth Patriarch. Okay, 六祖坛经，接着我要讲这个六祖坛经啊。And this sutra is one of the most important sutra of Zen Buddhism or Chan Buddhism, because from the sixth patriarch downward, all the Zen Buddhists need to study and learn this sutra. It is the hardcore of Zen Buddhism or Mahayana Zen Buddhism. And Zen Buddhism is admittedly the greatest contribution that Chinese Buddhism make to the civilization of China and the whole world too. Okay, so it's very great and important, and it gives you the most correct idea and understanding for Buddhism. And so I'm glad that you can attend this meeting, and for next year, I'll try and promise I will speak faster and make it shorter. Okay, and thank you very much for your coming and listening. The listening and practicing of this Diamond Sutra towards my own ultimate enlightenment, the supreme enlightenment. And I would vow to benefit all beings with this supreme Dharma. Thank you again.